morning. It's Friday, May 1st, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, An Honorable Life. And our scripture is from 1 Peter chapter 2, where the big fisherman writes, For the Lord's sake, submit to all human authority, whether the king as head of state or the officials he has appointed. For the king has sent them to punish those who do wrong and to honor those who do right. It is God's will that your honorable lives should silence those ignorant people who make foolish accusations against you. For you are free, yet you are God's slaves, so don't use your freedom as an excuse to do evil. Respect everyone and love the family of believers. Fear God and respect the king. Adolf Hitler, the Führer of Germany in the early to mid-20th century, was a passionate man who had little or no compassion for others. He knew what he wanted to accomplish, and his actions proved his methods built a life and legacy without honor. The man was a monster. It matters what you accomplish with your life, but frankly, it's just as important, and perhaps more important, how you do it. All the good, supposedly, intentions in the world are useless unless they're met with actions which honor the good you intend to do. It's said that an honorable life is where integrity for doing right meets living. Peter expressed this in six memorable words, Fear God and respect the king. Of course, the word fear means to honor or revere in the sense that we keep in mind God is sovereign, holy, and almighty. We fear or honor God by not neglecting God's way in our own actions. In so doing, we put to silence foolish accusations. There have been plenty of movements in recent years that are honorably conceived, such as Black Lives Matter, Me Too, and others of social justice, and these have plenty of strong basis in Scripture. Accomplishing racial, gender, and economic parity in the realms of freedom and human dignity are goals worthy of godly standard. But as previously stated, how these are achieved are also vitally central to the results. When a protest against some ungodly oppression or practice of one group toward another turns ugly, there is little honor for our God. A prime example of this is the collapse of decency and restraint in the early 1990s when the Rodney King riots in Los Angeles erupted over a police chase and savage beating of the suspect was caught on video. The ensuing inconclusive action by the legal system precipitated violent riots in which more than 50 people lost their lives over 6 days. It's one thing to protest violence, but when your protest is conveyed by violent means, it isn't fighting fire with fire. It's adding more unholy fuel to a raging downward spiral of hatred, fear, and unleashed evil. The Apostle Peter had a moment like that in the Garden of Gethsemane. Judas led the Roman guard to arrest Jesus, betraying the Son of God with a kiss on the cheek. Peter protested by swinging his sword and cutting off the ear of Malchus, the servant of the high priest. Peter's intention to prevent the crucifixion of Jesus was righteous, but his actions were not. Had Jesus not stepped in and stopped the hostilities by healing Malchus' injury, there might have been a dozen crucifixions that day. Added violence never solves anything. It certainly can never be called honorable in anyone's life. For you today, the difference between loving peace and making peace is as wide as night and day. Loving peace merely requires thinking and supposing you're right in the way you conceive peace ought to look. To be a peacemaker requires putting your motives and your methods on trial in your heart every waking moment and living with what the court of conscience rules. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.